A lot of work goes into making a movie, especially an animated one. From concept, to writing, to the years of animation and eventual movie release, a lot can happen. Hello everybody, I'm Abby, and I'm coming at you with this top 10 video to share with you 10 scary truths behind some of your favorite Disney movies. Number 10, The Rescuers, and the number 13. So, to ease into all of the scary truths, we are exploring a true fear that one of the main characters from The Rescuers has. Main Mouse Bernard has a fear of the number 13. The number 13 is commonly associated with bad luck in Western culture. When you go to a hotel, many don't have a 13th floor because they don't want to associate with bad luck. Bernard's fear is next level though, making it enough to be a phobia. Triskaidekaphobia, to be exact. This is a written account of this fear, the number 13, dates back only to the late 1800s, but became common enough by 1911 that it got the name Triskaidekaphobia by combining the Greek word for 13 with phobia, which means a fear of. All in all, our boy Bernard from The Rescuers has some strong feelings about the number 13. Do you have strong feelings about any numbers too? Any particular ones? Also, I have another truth about The Rescuers, and this one was a bit of a scandal, so grab some tea and get ready to get into it. That brings us to number 9, The Rescuers' Hidden Photo. Although the film came out in 1977 and was out on Laserdisc and VHS since 1992, no issue was found until 1999. The issue was with an objectionable background image about 38 minutes into the movie. This image was of a topless woman that was in two frames of the movie when Bianca and Bernard fly in on a sardine box on the back of Orville through the city. An important thing to note is that the frame rate for Disney movies is between 24 and 60 frames per second. So, only being visible for two frames means that the image was only visible for a 12th of a second, which is about 0.083 seconds. So, who broke the news about this if you could only find it by freeze framing at the right moment, knowing when that moment is? Disney did. That's right. They made a public statement about it, saying it must have been inserted in post-production, and that they were recalling 3.4 million copies of the movie. That's a lot of VHS tapes. Could it have been a publicity stunt?
I don't know.
Number 8, Disney and recycling animations. This truth has been going around for a bit, but I wanted to include it because there's a bit of misinformation buzzing around it as well. If you look at the hand-drawn animated Disney movies, there can be some overlap in how some sequences turn out in the final production. For example, there's a movement in Robin Hood that looks an awful lot like some movement in Aristocats, and the dance scene in Beauty and the Beast looks the same as the one in Sleeping Beauty. This has led to a lot of outlets saying that the animators were recycling animation for either time or money, you know, all those reasons, and they kind of jumped to conclusions in some cases, because this wasn't always the case. In 2015, on his website GeekDad, Jim McQuarrie asked former animators on these movies what really had happened in these situations. Animator Floyd Norman said it was because of director Wolfgang Wooley Reitherman. According to Norman, Reitherman liked to play it safe and only use stuff he knew would work, which led to similar animation over many of the movies he directed. Also, Gary Tousdale, co-director of Beauty and the Beast, said time was the reason for the dance scene making you see double. As they were kind of cut for time, Reitherman had already made it so that using previous sequences was alright, so Tousdale said they resized and repositioned the Sleeping Beauty animation and then cleaned up the characters to make them look like the ones you see in Beauty and the Beast. Changed the colors too. This information was shocking to me, so I had to share it, and okay, I know it's not the spookiest, but the next few make up for that. Alright, that brings us to number 7, Finding Nemo and Other Lost Fish. In the movie, Nemo escapes the dentist down the toilet believing that all drains lead to the ocean. And this idea had influence. Children began flushing their fish down the toilet, believing this was true. The LA Times wrote about this and also what really happens to the fish when they are flushed down the toilet. Because no, they don't go to the ocean. First of all, most flushed fish die from trauma or shock from hitting fresh water if they're a saltwater fish. If a fish survives the swirling journey, they still won't make it to open waters though. They would end up in a sewage system where the bacteria, chemicals, and gases would poison or drown the fish with asphyxiation. But if somehow your fish was super strong somehow and they still would try, they still wouldn't make it because the only thing that makes it to open water is water. The fish would be taken out as a solid at a water treatment plant. So don't flush your fish, please, especially if they're alive. Alright, number 6, Princess and the Frog. 2 months after its release in 2010, an article came out in Metro that said young Disney fans had fallen ill after kissing frogs, like in the movie. This article was citing a salmonella outbreak in the States, but it wasn't known for certain that it was because of kissing frogs, so it's likely that this story was spun. That being said, there's truth in one part of it. Kissing frogs can give you salmonella. Amphibians are well known to carry salmonella and can give humans the infection salmonellosis from contact with them. It's advised young children don't mirror the princess in having a frog of their own because of their weakened immune systems, so just don't go around kissing frogs, cause catch a bunch of stuff. Now let's jump from frogs back to fish. Or half fish, that is. Brings us to number 5, The Little Mermaid. And the Little Mermaid song that was almost cut. We all know, regardless of how much you liked it, that The Little Mermaid is a classic. The thing is, it could have been released without its iconic song, Part of Your World, and that's terrifying. In a Polygon interview with Jodie Benson, the voice of Ariel, she said that in early test screenings, the song didn't perform well, which is absurd. The 4-minute song wasn't doing well with its target audience, kids. The Disney chairman at the time, Jeffrey Katzenberg, noticed kids were getting restless and distracted during the song, even throwing popcorn around, and he wanted to axe the song. What saved this beautiful song was the song's lyricist, Howard Ashman, who apparently said, "If this song goes, I go." And to that, I've gotta say, thank you, Howard Ashman, for an anthem. On to number 4, A Sleeping Beauty Truth. So, The Little Mermaid came out in 1989, 30 years after the last princess movie, Sleeping Beauty. And why? Well, Sleeping Beauty wasn't the only sleeping thing with this movie. The movie originally bombed. Called a sleeper movie because of its delayed profits, and possibly because it put theatergoers to sleep, the movie originally only made $5.3 million. If you're looking at me like, Abby, what about inflation? Just stop there, kid. It cost $6 million to make the movie originally, so it originally came out as a loss. Now, though, it's nearly 10 times the original $5 million with a lifetime gross of $51.6 million. So it kind of grew from there. If you ever showcase something and it's not getting stellar reviews, don't sweat it, because Sleeping Beauty, it shows. People barely remember the truth that it bombed. So don't get too worked up about your own personal failures. Now let's go to another princess with number 3, Tangled's Pricey Truth. Adjusted for inflation, as I talked about earlier, Sleeping Beauty cost a little over $53 million with today's valuation. And that pales in comparison with Tangled. Tangled is the most expensive animated movie Disney has ever made. It's also the most expensive animated movie of all time. It is my favorite Disney movie though, so obviously it was worth it, you know. The studio spent an estimated $260 million back in 2010 to make Tangled. That's a quarter of $1 billion. Also, Ranker adjusted against 2019 inflation to say that it would be equivalent to $320 million today. And it's more expensive than the Titanic to make. And Titanic the movie, not the boat, I'm not sure about that. But why was it so expensive? Some people think it's because there was storyboarding and writing dating back to 2000, 10 years before the movie's release, but there are no sure answers out there right now. The good news, though, is Disney more than doubled their profit with a gross profit of over $590 million. Also, talking about profitable, let's jump to number 2, Frozen. And specifically, Frozen names are references. Frozen's original title was going to be The Snow Queen, which is also the name of the work that the movie was based on. Pardon me here, Snedragonin, I hope I pronounced that right, aka The Snow Queen, was written by Hans Christian Andersen. When you think of that name, countless childhood stories may come into your head, but listen to it again. Hans Christian Andersen. Now, listen to 4 main characters in Frozen. Hans Christoph Anna Sven. Hans Christoph Anna Sven. Hans Christian Andersen. I rest my case. Also, the 4 names were confirmed on the Frozen IMDb to be a reference to the author. A little something snuck in there. Also, on another note, what's another thing characters Christoph, Anna, and Sven have in common? No mothers. Which brings us to number 1, no mother characters. You may have noticed how a lot of Disney characters don't have mothers, or parents, but specifically mothers. This could be because many Disney tales are based on old fairy tales where they too, there, didn't have mothers, or either parent. But this could also have been for other reasons, and Disney producer Don Hahn, or Don Hahn, gave 2 more in an interview with Glamour. 2 more reasons, that is. The first reason Hahn said there wouldn't be any parents is because of plot. Most Disney movies are about growing up and accepting responsibility, and a quick way of doing that is losing your parent, or both parents. An example he used was of Belle from Beauty and the Beast. She only had her father, and then her father was taken away, so she had to step up, grow up. The second explanation for no mother was because of Walt Disney's past. Walt's mother died tragically in a house that Walt bought for his parents. A carbon monoxide leak from the furnace hospitalized his father and led to his mother's death. Walt Disney was traumatized and felt personally responsible. From there, Hahn says that's why Walt steered away from mother characters in future films. I know that last one was sad, but it's important to know that it wasn't Walt's fault, and regardless of the tragedy that happened, he has and continues to impact many lives with his stories of growth. Now that you've heard some of the truths behind these stories, what do you think? Did you have a favorite or one that stuck out to you? Which ones caught you off guard. If you know of other scary truths, let me know in the comments below, and while you're down there, toss me a like and hit subscribe for more most amazing top 10 videos. Once again, I'm Abby, and thanks for watching. Stick around and watch a playlist too, just while you're here. Alright, have a good one.